we stand together with our teachers and we are asking the government to negotiate, to get on the dialogue table and negotiate with the lecturers, because we all understand it is because of government having failed in its primary responsibility of implementing whatever they had agreed on, their pact, some 2 years ago. So we feel that this is a moment of shame to the government, and it should swallow its ego and get back on the table, because since then, many things have changed. Things have skyrocketed. The cost of living has gone so high. And we don't want a scenario whereby our teachers cannot afford to drive to the lecture rooms, or they cannot afford basic standards of living that is expected of a teacher. We are not ready to go home. We are not ready to have a disrupted academic calendar. And we don't want the government to start testing the faith and patience of the young people in the universities. If they want to go that path, then I think they'll be courting hot fire, which will take them very many years to put out. We feel 70,000 as basic minimum loan awarded is what we are asking for. On the maximum, we are only asking for 120, because currently 60,000 is the maximum one can receive, and 35,000 is the basic minimum a student can receive. At this time, like at the University of Nairobi, without any fear of contradiction, fee per year stands at 41,000 Kenya shillings. And minimum basic loan awarded to some students is 35. So as you get this loan, you are already in a negative 6,000. You have not eaten, you've not put on clothes. So do we want to walk to the lecture halls naked? Should we walk there on empty stomachs? Should we not buy materials to study? So why give a person school fees and deny him food? If relief food is being taken to Northeastern and Turkana, then it should also be brought to our universities, because we also have students there who are suffering. So the government should engage Red Cross to bring relief food to universities or increase our loan. And that's what we are saying.
The lecturers should be paid well so that they deliver better services to our students. The government should negotiate with the lecturers and pay them their due, for dialogue is not a weakness. We further recommend, we further want the government to increase the Higher Education Loan Board. This was revised in the early 90s, and up to date, nothing has been done about it. There's very high cost of living. This leads to students leading double standard lives. The money that is given to the students at an average of 40,000 for the whole year is not enough for the students to survive. They use almost 3/4 of the amount on school fees. Then how can a normal student survive with the remaining 1/4 of the amount for the rest of the year? We are giving the government an ultimatum of 2 weeks to respond to this issue. Otherwise, whatever we'll be doing or we are capable of doing is wearing a hat.